In this video, we will going to discuss method of grouping to solve the linear partial differential equation. For this, we consider the auxiliary equations dx by p equal to dy by q equal dz by r. In this model, we can choose any two fractions from the set of the three fractions. If suppose we consider the first fraction, second fraction, that means dx by p equal to dy by q, then this is solvable if z is absent or cancel out z from p and q. That means we can find the solution from dx by p equal to dy by q if the first point is p and q may contain x comma y and does not contain z. Second point is if suppose p and q contains z and if we are able to remove z from p and q by cancelling it. In that case also we can find the solution. The question is, when will you are not able to find the solution from these two fractions? The answer is, if you are not able to remove z from p and q, in that case you cannot find the solution from these two fractions. I explain this with the following examples. In the first example, we have dx by y equal to dy by x. By cross multiplying, that means by the using method of variable separable, we can solve it. In the second case, the denominator of dx contains z and the denominator of dy contains z, but we can cancel out z from these two denominators. Then we can solve it. That means we can find the solution. But in case of third example, the denominator of dx is x square minus z and the denominator of dy is y square minus z. In this case, we cannot remove z from these two denominators. That means we are not able to find the solution from these two fractions. Similarly, we consider another set of two fractions. That means second fraction and third fraction. Dy by q equal to dz by r. Now we can find the solution from these two fractions if the first point is q comma r may contains y comma z and does not contain x, and the second point is if suppose q comma r contains x and we are able to cancel out x from q and r, in that case also we can find the solution. Here the question is, when will you are not able to find the solution from these two functions? The answer is, if you are not able to cancel out x from the denominators q and r, in that case you cannot find the solution from these two functions. Another set of two fractions are dx by p equal to dz by r. These two functions can be solvable if the first point is the denominators p comma r may contains x comma z and does not contains y. Second point is if suppose p comma r contains y and we are able to remove y from p and r, in that case also we can find the solution. Here the question is, when will you cannot find the solution from these two fractions? The answer is, if you are not able to cancel out y from these two denominators, in that case you cannot find the solution from these two fractions. Here we have the note. To write the general solution f of u comma v equal to 0, you must need two linearly independent solutions. In some problems you can able to find the solution, one solution u equal to c1, but you cannot find the second solution by using above procedure. In that case, you can use the solution which we obtained previously in the auxiliary equations to get the second solution. I will explain it in the following example. Suppose if we consider the auxiliary equations are like this. We can easily solve this. Then we get the first solution x by y equal to c1. We get the one solution. But by considering second and third fractions from the denominator, we cannot eliminate x. That means by taking dy dz, the denominators may contain y comma z, does not contain x. But here we cannot eliminate x. So in that case, we can use the first solution to get the second solution. That means we can substitute x by y equal to c1 here. Then that is dy by y equal to dz by z plus c1. Here we have dy by y equal dz by z plus c1. In these two denominators, we contains y comma z, but does not contains x. Hence, we can find the solution from these two fractions.